Hi there, I'm Kevin Kittredge, and 324 South Glen Oaks Boulevard, Burbank, California. Right now, it's a Raffy's Market, but this used to be a Blockbuster. Now, I've already done a story about this before, actually. If you do a little hashtag search on, Instagram and whatnot, this used to be a Blockbuster. You'll find the story about how I had to move like 6 or 7 big boxes of DVD on top of the roof overnight to hide them from my regional manager. And he didn't look on the roof. It was great. You'll find that video of me actually at that Raffy's Market as opposed to here in the studio. But this story starts on a Saturday morning. I'm coming to open the store. I get there about 8:30 or so. We open at 10. I get there about 8:30, 8:45. There's mustard on all the windows. It's crazy. Mustard all over the windows in the Dropbox. It's disgusting. Now I'm thinking to myself, Friday night, crazy kids. Oh, I used to be young once. A little frustrated, but what are you going to do? So I go in, I open the safe, I get the deposit, take it to the bank. I come back, start cleaning up mustard. The next day, Sunday, I get to work again, mustard everywhere. Now I'm a little bit more pissed off. Pretty upset. But again, what are you gonna do? So I went in, got the deposit, took it to the bank, came back, cleaned up mustard. Monday, I came in at noon by my assistant manager, Jen. She came in to open the store. And when I got there at noon, she was like, oh, Kev, it's terrible. Got to work, there's mayonnaise all over the windows. I was like, oh man, now I'm really upset because I'm the store manager, it happens to me, whatever. But she doesn't get paid enough to deal with that. So I'm really upset. What are you gonna do? So Tuesday, I come to work, guess what? There's mustard on the windows. And this is when I completely lose it. I am nuclear. So I change up my regime. I'm so mad, I don't take the deposit at the bank right away. I go in, shut the alarm off, I get the cleaning equipment, I come outside, and I start cleaning mustard. As I do it, I feel this pressure in the back of my waist. And I turn and I saw this guy. And I'm gonna tell you, above this guy in bright Broadway letters flashing over and over, I saw the words, failed screenwriter. This guy's a little bit taller than me. I'm 6'2 and change, he's taller than me. Got red curly hair under a baseball cap, wearing glasses. He's got a fuzzy beard, very, very little, nothing like this. I'm telling you, he was a failed screenwriter. Anyway, I turned to him and he says, you're gonna open the door, you're gonna open the safe, you're gonna give me the money. And this is one of those moments where, you know, life is rushing so fast, the adrenaline's pumping, everything slows down. And I assess smartly in that time, I'm a lot safer outside the store than I am inside with this guy. So I say, I'm cleaning mustard. And I go back to cleaning the mustard. He says, again, you're gonna open the door, you're gonna open the safe, you're gonna give me the money. And I said, man, there's mustard here, here, and here. There's mustard everywhere. I gotta open the store. I got too much shit to do. I'm cleaning mustard. He says, I don't care. You're gonna open that door. You're gonna open that safe. You're gonna give me the money. Yesterday it was mayonnaise, I say to this guy, incredulously. Now, I had not put together that it was clearly this guy that was doing all this stuff. I don't know how this story would have happened if I figured it out. But I say, yesterday was mayonnaise. He says, come on, man, I'll make it worth your while. Again, really fast thinking in my head. I'm like, it's Tuesday. Yesterday was Monday. Nobody rents movies on a Monday. And nobody pays in cash. It's all debit cards and credit cards. There's probably $600 in cash there. If he splits it with me 50-50, I'm getting $300. Am I selling out my soul and betraying my company for $300? I don't know what my price is. Everybody has a price. Just ask Ted DiBiase. But I know that my price is not $300. The idea was laughable. And I just said, eh, no. And I kept cleaning the mustard. And he says, this is so surreal. I can't believe you won't do this with me. And I'm trying to think of how to explain to him, I'm a good person. I am not a thief. I'm not gonna steal from my own company. I'm not gonna steal from my own store. And I'm trying to figure out how to word this for him. And all I can blubble up is, I'm from Minnesota. And he says, I'm from the Midwest too. I don't know what to tell you, man. So I continue cleaning, and he stands there just looking at me, and he goes, well, the better man won. And he puts out his hand for me to shake, and I shook his hand, and he said, do me a favor. Just give me a couple of minutes before you call the cops, all right? And he skedaddles. Now, it is to my shame. I know I don't want to give the impression that I was not scared. I was actually pretty scared. I shouldn't have been. He didn't have a gun. But, you know, what are you going to do? I was very scared in the moment from this guy who was trying to rob me. And I actually did wait like a minute. And then I was like, yeah, that's a pretty good idea. I should probably call the cops. I mean, I didn't know what the point would be. He was long gone. He was going to be gone even if I went right away. They weren't going to be able to catch him. But I was like, oh, I should probably call the cops. And I called loss prevention. And loss prevention called my district manager. So Diana, my district manager, she comes into the store. She's like, Kevin, never do that again. You always give him the money. I was like, Diana, I was safer outside the store than inside with him. And she was just like, ah. And she went to the gift card rack. She picked one up. And I'm like, oh, all right, she's buying stuff. So she buys a $50 gift card. I sell it to her. She instantly hands it over to me and says, do never do that again. And in my head, I'm like, you are rewarding me for doing this. But no, I wasn't going to push it. I was like, oh, well, thank you. And she left. And I instantly used that gift card to buy the Back to the Future trilogy on DVD, which just came out that day. So it is easy to remember that day. Not only is it the day that Back to the Future came out on DVD, the trilogy, but I do have the Burbank Police Department citizen information card. Attempted robbery on December 17th, 2002. There it is. 324 South Glen Oaks Boulevard. This used to be a Blockbuster.